Michelle and France, of the minister on the roster, and to you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Today, our theme is balance and unity in adversity through Sunday school. Psalms 133, verse 1 through 3. Adversity is basically variety. Variety of people within a group. The difference among the people being racial, cultural, gender-based, etc. Adversity was God's idea. He did not create us as clones or robots. The angels and elders around God's throne adorned Jesus with words, "With your blood you purchased for God persons from every tribe and language and people and nation." Revelation 5:9. So God enjoyed the diversity within the human race. We are each created in his image for his pleasure and glory. Revelation 4:11, Colossians 1:16. We tend to look at diversity to highlight our differences instead of focusing on the one who created that diversity. God is more concerned with unity. Ephesians 4:3. Galatians 3:28 says, "There's neither Jew nor Gentile, neither slave nor free, nor is there male or female. With you are all in one in Jesus Christ." God is saying that our differences are not what should define us as children of God. Those who belong to the Lord Jesus should first define themselves as God's children. We must be willing to set adversity aside in favor of unity and spirit. David stated that harmony is pleasure and precious. Unfortunately, harmony does not abound in the church as it should. People disagree and cause division among unimportant issues. Some delight and cause tension by discrediting us. Harmony is important because, number one, it makes the church a positive example to give the world to help draw us to the Lord. We learn this as little children when we attend Sunday school. Number two, it helps us cooperate as a body of believers as God meant us to, giving us a foretaste of heaven. When we were a child, we understood as a child. But when we put God in our heart, we put away childish things. Number three, it renews and revitalizes ministry because there is less tension to sap our energy and take our attention away from the things that God would have us to do. Satan is always busy. He's trying to turn us away from God. Living in harmony does not mean we will agree on everything. There will be many opinions, just as there are many notes in a musical chorus. But we must agree on our purpose in this to work together for God. Jesus' passionate prayer in John 12 shows that his desire for his disciples was that they may be one as you and I are one, verse 22. So what does it mean to be one? When we are born again, John 3, we are created anew in Christ. Our fleshly difference becomes secondary to our new nature in Christ. We have one Lord, one faith, one baptism, Ephesians 4:5. Regardless of racial, cultural, or gender difference, God's children hold his word as their final authority on all matters. We will have adversity in this life. But if we put God first in our life, we can balance unity in adversity. I thank you, and may God bless you.